Panthers hosting the Packers. And after yesterday's game, Panthers owner Jerry Richardson announced he would be selling the team at the end of the season. The move came after Sports Illustrated posted an article alleging workplace misconduct by Richardson. The NFL is investigating the allegations. Up numbers like never before. In last night's win over Washington, LeBron notched his third straight triple-double and sixth of the season, tying the longest triple-double streak of his career. I'm Antonita Collins. The Ezekiel Elliott wait is over. After serving a six-game suspension, Zeke can return to the Cowboys. It should be an extreme boost for a team with playoff hopes still alive, thanks in part to a piece of paper. In case you missed it, this has the Seahawks in a position they haven't been in since 2011. They're on the verge of missing the playoffs. Seattle is now two games behind the Rams, who have all but locked up the NFC West title with two games left. So what was key for Los Angeles? Ended up playing for a chance to control their own playoff destiny against the Buccaneers, who honored John Gruden, the winningest coach in franchise history and the only one to win a Super Bowl in Tampa Bay. Last night over the Nuggets, thanks in part to a season-high 38 points from Russell Westbrook. OKC improves to 10-4 at home this season. Here's how they are back to work today, but Elliott included. It will be the running back's first training session with the team since he was banned in late October. Zeke comes back to a team with a three-game winning streak and a lot of hope, so how much will they use him? Just keep rolling. Houston ran their winning streak to 14 games last night with a comeback win over Utah. Let's show you how they got things done. Two's ahead for Tom Brady. Patriots head coach Bill Belichick has reportedly stripped Alex Guerrero from team privileges, adding speculation to a rift between Belichick and Tom Brady's longtime friend, trainer, mentor, and business partner. Guerrero has been a guiding force in Brady's effort to build TB12 into a national brand. It had a matchup between the King and the Greek Freak last night. It was a thriller in Milwaukee. The Bucks blew a late 20-point lead, but still found a way to win. In case back in just a minute, I'm Antonita Collins, a move that pretty much didn't shock anyone. The Packers has shut down Aaron Rodgers for what's left of the season. With Green Bay out of the playoffs, they've placed two-time NFL MVP on injured reserve. Rodgers, who missed seven games after he broke his right clavicle in October, returned Sunday. Collins, despite James Harden dropping 51 points, the Lakers were able to end the Rockets' 14-game win streak with a 122-116 victory. Houston may have lost for the first time since November 14th, but the bigger concern this morning, the health of Chris Paul. LaVar Ball said yesterday that he has found a long-awaited solution to an ongoing problem. Ball said he is launching a basketball league for nationally ranked players who have graduated from high school but don't want to make that pit stop out of college before being eligible for the NBA draft. Ball's Junior Basketball Association will be funded by his Big Baller brand. For more on this idea, let's take it back. Since MLB Commissioner Rob Manfred was on the Dan Le Batard show Wednesday afternoon, where things got testy between the two, especially when Dan wanted straight-up answers on Derek Jeter and the new ownership group's plans with the Marlins. Quarterback Cam Newton has admitted that the days after Sports Illustrated's article reporting allegations for sexual and racial misconduct against team owner Jerry Richardson have been difficult. The quarterback explained why he's standing up for the only owner he has ever played for. Steelers, who are coming off their first loss in more than 2 months, are looking to bounce back this Christmas Day when they take on the Texans. When speaking to the media Wednesday, quarterback Ben Roethlisberger made it very clear that the Patriots are the thing of the past and the focus is on Houston. Good news for the Falcons, who have a chance to clinch a playoff berth with a win over the Saints this Sunday. They'll have the services of running back Tevin Coleman, who this week cleared the concussion protocol. However, there is one injury to keep an eye on for Atlanta. We now know why Lakers guard Kentavious Caldwell-Pope missed recent road games against the Cavaliers and Rockets. Caldwell-Pope is currently serving a 25-day sentence after violating his probation, according to the Los Angeles Times. Under a California work release program, Caldwell-Pope can leave the detention facility to attend practice and play in Lakers' home game. Bonita Collins, the former Louisville basketball player at the center of a federal investigation which led to Rick Pitino's firing, says he had no knowledge of an alleged scheme to pay his father $100,000. ESPN's Jeff Goodman spoke exclusively with Brian Bowen yesterday. Bowen was suspended from the Louisville basketball program this fall after news broke out about the federal investigation. He then left the school after Louisville chose not to seek NCAA reinstatement for Bowen. Collins, Sunday, Tre'Davious White and the Bills face Rob Gronkowski in the Pats for the first time since his vicious late hit earlier this month. Many eyes will be on Gronk to see if revenge will be a factor. However, this time around, the tight end may be more focused on his numbers on the field. So now let's get it back to First Take. Play by Carlos Santana.
See, as the rich is getting richer, the poor.